Ok, questa è la seconda parte della lezione di 13 ottobre. Partiamo con le domande. Qui abbiamo preso, diciamo, utilizzando, in questo caso si chiamano coordinati polari, x e y sono espressi tra l'angolo θ1, x2, y2 con l'angolo θ2. Abbiamo calcolato il prodotto. Proviamo a vedere qual è la parte che serve se c'è qualche punto non chiaro. Ecco, spesso quando abbiamo, torniamo al nostro delle oscillatori, nel nostro modello di Kuramoto possiamo dire che oscillatore The oscillator is practically represented by a complex number that in general is a complex number x plus e y with, from the very beginning, we set this zeta is on the circle of radius r. Which means x square plus y square equal r. But we know that this means simply that modulus of zeta is square root of x square plus y square. Due to the Pythagorean theorem, this modulus is x square plus y square. And this is exactly r. So for us, oscillator, this is complex number with modulus, fixed modulus R. And our model in neuroscience, Kuramoto model, practically models behavior of many oscillators, many zetas. And here we simply start to find one oscillator, theta 1 shall be r times, because x, if this is r, and this is theta 1, what is x? X shall be r times cosine theta, x divided by r by definition of the by definition of the trigonometric function cosine is this divided by this. So this is the definition of cosine. And this means x1 is r times cosine theta. This is our x1 plus, then we have the same r sine of theta 1 with I in front. So this here is x1, this here is y1, and oscillator, zeta1 oscillator, has modulus r, and cosine theta sine theta 1 can be taken after parentheses, therefore we can put r times cos theta 1 plus I sine theta 1. What is the difference between our example in this case? We simply have radius r, not 1, but our complex number is the same. The only difference is this factor r. In the same way, we consider the oscillator z2 shall be r. Now we change the phase. Instead of theta 1, we take a phase theta 2, cosine theta 2 plus I sine theta 2. And we can compute simply, for example, let us compute now zeta 1, zeta 2. This calculation we already did when r is 1. But you see, if you have here r, in the product you simply multiply r square, take this, and then you multiply these two complex numbers that we already have calculated. Therefore, this is cosine theta 1 plus theta 2 plus I sine theta 1 plus theta 2. And therefore, the result is very simple. The product of two oscillators practically has as radius r square, and then we have the phase that is the sum of the phases of our oscillators, zeta 1 and zeta 2. This explains why, if we want to be on the same circle, it is better to take R1, because in the product we are again on the circle with R1. This is not surprising if you take, for example, third oscillator, R cos theta 3 plus I sine theta 3. What we shall get zeta 1, zeta 2, zeta 3. This is this by this. This gives r to the power 3. And then again, we apply the rule. Take this guy and multiply by this. This is the phase. This is the phase here. What is the result? The result is the same cosine plus e sine. But now, this, we have to put theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3. So we have theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3. And the same is the result for sine theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3. So this is practically small calculation that shows that for oscillators, we have to add the phases. For you, I shall leave as exercise to compute zeta 1, zeta 2 bar, complex conjugate, and find here result. We shall make such exercises in order to have more abilities to work with complex numbers. Okay. Before going, let me ask if these small simulations with three oscillators is clear. For us, oscillators are complex number with fixed modulus and phase that may be, in the first case, theta 1, in the second case, the phase is theta 2, and when we take the product, we have to take the sum of the phases. Okay, let's ask you for your questions. Actually, this is nice use. In this case, what is the relation we have used? X is R cosine theta. Epsilon was R sine theta. These are Cartesian coordinates. The point is defined by two real numbers, while R and theta are polar coordinates. Here we use polar coordinates or spherical polar coordinates. Using polar coordinates, we can represent our complex number zeta. We can represent our we can take our zeta, that was x plus epsilon, and this we represent as r times sine theta plus I sine theta. This is known as trigonometric representation of the complex number. Representation. This is especially useful for our oscillator because R usually is interpreted as amplitude of our oscillator, while theta is interpreted as a phase. There is another notation because this expression is used very frequently. Mathematicians, they used abbreviate expression for this particular complex number. So let us see what are the properties of this complex number. If I write in trigonometric form with modulus 1, what you can say about modulus of this complex number? When you take the square, this is cosine square theta plus sine. We already computed. And of course, cosine square plus sine square is always 1. This specific expression, cosine theta plus I sine theta, instead of being so long, there is very compact representation that mathematicians introduced. This is by definition, is e to the power e theta. So simply notation, by definition, e at the point in the exponent e theta is this expression. Instead of writing long expression, we use e to the power e theta. This seems only formal notation, but this formal notation is quite useful for calculations. Why? Because our previous examples show that e to e theta 1, if I take this complex number and multiply by e to the power e theta 2, what is the rule? We said that this is again cosine with sum of phases. So this is a e theta 1 plus theta 2. And this is something that is quite similar to usual rule for the exponents. Remember that if I write a to the power a, A to the power B for AB reals, we have A to the power A plus B. So it turns out that this rule continues to be valid not only for AB real, but for AB complex. So we know what is A to the power E one. If we know what is this, then it is quite simple. For example, compute. E, what you can say about A to the power E theta multiplied by A to the power E theta? If you multiply two complex numbers with the same face, what shall be the result? A to the power E 2 times theta. And this is quite similar to the usual rule, this to the power 2 by definition is this by this. So the for taking a to the power a to the power n was the rule for the real numbers. This was a to the power a n. We multiply this exponent by a. The same rule is true here for the faces. If you have to take third power, then you have to take three multipliers and you have to put three. If you have five multipliers, here you have to put five, and so on. So this trigonometric representation, and especially this representation of the complex numbers, is quite useful. So here you can put R A to the power e theta. This is due to our notation, is the trigonometric representation. Sometimes it is the name of Moivre, but I prefer to avoid names and say that it is trigonometric representation. And we have really nice rules for making products of different oscillators. Okay. Now we can try to make our first model connected with one oscillator. Of course, when we have more oscillators, we shall have a more complicated system. How we can model, and in this way we shall make small exercise. When we made the model of increasing population, Malthus model, we had the following. Let us write now. Section devoted to differential equations with complex numbers. We said that the set of all complex numbers is denoted by C. Remember a simple example. X point t is equal constant a times x t. When x is a number, of course, here we can put find the solution. X zero is let us say fixed constant c. this equation at the beginning of our course we solved explicitly. How? Divided, because variables are separated, divided by x, integrating. Our final solution was xt is c a to the power at. This is the precise solution of this equation. This means if a is positive, x is increasing exponentially when t goes to infinity, plus infinity. And if a is negative, goes very rapidly to zero. Now, let us try to understand what we will have if we have one zeta t, that is xt plus e epsilon t. Formally, we can pose a similar equation to one. Therefore, to write zeta point is equal a times zeta. For the moment, we shall say our model starts with real a. If I put index plus, r plus means interval 0 infinity, means a is positive. How we can treat the find the solution of this equation? Of course, there is a very simple way to solve this now we have to put also initial data, but at least to solve this equation. What we have to do? Simply have differential equation with complex zeta, you take your expression x plus e epsilon and substitute here. So if you have zeta point, how you compute the derivative? You simply take the derivative of x at the point t plus I derivative of epsilon at the point t. And with the help of this simple rule, we can substitute in our equation 2. And therefore, we shall have in the left-hand side, x point t plus e epsilon point t. Now on the right-hand side, I have to multiply my positive a by zeta. And again, I substitute zeta with x plus. So I get a xt plus e a epsilon t. Of course, this equation is again equation with complex numbers. Somehow, we can immediately see the real part in the left-hand side. This, for example, is real. This is real. So whenever you have relation of this type, if you have alpha 1 plus e beta 1 equal alpha 2 plus e beta 2, if alpha and beta are real, and if you have this relation, then immediately you say, okay, real is equal to the real. Alpha 1 equal alpha 2. And imaginary part beta 1 is equal beta 2. Therefore, from this equation, we can from this equation, using this rule, when you have two complex numbers, you compare real parts and then you take them equal. You take imaginary parts and they take equal. So since this is real, while this is I real, we shall take only the real part. X point is equal a x. This is the first relation. And the other relation is beta 1 equal beta 2. So we have epsilon point t is a epsilon t. And as you can see, each of these equations is like this one. Therefore, if you put initial data here, zeta 0 equal, let us take 1 plus e c2. Initial data for complex valued function, they are really always complex valued. So here we shall put x0 is c1, y0 is c2. And we can, for each of these two lines, we can solve our equation using this solution. So xt shall be sum a to the power at, yt shall be c2 a to the power at. Finally, we can express our zeta t. Zeta t is x plus e epsilon. So this is a to the power t. And here I have c1 plus e c2. This is the solution. And as you can see, when we have model involving complex numbers, we can produce and work in the same way as with the real numbers. Of course, in some cases, it is much more complicated to use the complex numbers. Okay, let me stop for the moment with this example and ask you for your questions. I am sorry for this, shall try to solve. Meanwhile, please to prepare your questions. I shall try to solve the problem with the sum. I think this is the maximum for the moment, unfortunately.
Professore, scusi.
Sì.
C'è una domanda sciocca, una cosa di notazione, ma...
Prego.
La X col puntino o comunque la Z per cosa stanno? All'inizio non ho capito.
Ah, X puntino sta per la derivata della funzione X rispetto a T. Perché x dipende da x puntino, spesso si usa questo x primo di t, oppure dx di t in t, oppure i fisici usano x pontino di t perché sono pigrie minimo sforzi.
Va bene, grazie.
Prego. Ok, altre domande? Mi dispiace per il sole, ma tra noi siamo quasi alla lezione, così cerchiamo di vedere prima di tutto le vostre domande. Noi certamente il nostro scopo principale sarà di tornare ai nostri modelli, dare l'idea. Maggior numero dei nostri modelli sarà come qui, 2x2. E adesso posso dare solo in questo angolo dove non c'è sole, anzi faccio così. Qui praticamente, ecco così. Possiamo
Professore.
usare solo questo angolo, così è meglio.
Si abbassa magari un pochettino.
No, no, ma io uso solo questa
Ah,
della lavagna,
ok.
perché il
Possiamo
sole è sopra.
vedere un esempio magari proprio di quest'ultimo concetto?
Come?
Un esempio magari proprio di questa, di quest'ultima equazione?
Ah, va bene, un altro esempio, già con numeri concreti.
Esatto, sì, grazie.
Ok. Ecco, per esempio. Mi sembra il sole non arriva. Useremo la parte superiore della linea. Esempio brevissimo che può essere capito meglio. Allora, adesso uso la notazione z' uguale a 2 volte z0 uguale a 1 più i. Sappiamo che z, che è funzione di t, dipende da xt più iyt. E che cosa facciamo? Facciamo la sostituzione. Qui x' di t più iy' di t è la derivata di z. Deve essere 2 volte z. Sostituisco dappertutto z con xt più 2i con t. Dopo la sostituzione io ho qui parte reale, reale, parte immaginaria, parte immaginaria. E lì confronto significa parte reale uguale a parte reale, cioè x' di t è uguale a 2 volte. Abbiamo parte immaginaria y' di t uguale a 2 volte yt. Adesso devo tornare ai miei dati iniziali. Quando voi prendete t uguale a 0, avete x0, z0 e x0 più y0. Che cosa possiamo dire per x0? È la parte reale di z0, ma la parte reale di z0 è 1. Guardiamo y0, è la parte immaginaria di z0, ma la parte immaginaria di z0 è 1, perché i non c'è nulla, quindi il fattore è 1. E quindi io ho queste due equazioni che sono completamente separate. La prima equazione io posso risolvere in modo esplicito. Abbiamo xt è 1 per e all'esponente 2t. Questa è la mia soluzione. Infatti controllo se non siete sicuri. X primo subito esce fattore 2 e questo mi dà 2xt, quindi x soddisfa questa equazione. X0, quando t è 0, questo è 1, quindi verifico questa proprietà. E qui trovo anche yt. Yt sarà la stessa soluzione. 1 per e all'esponente 2t. Ecco la mia soluzione qui e qui. E adesso possiamo trovare la soluzione finale, zt, sarà e all'esponente 2t, perché e all'esponente 2t, e all'esponente 2t si ripete, e dentro abbiamo 1 più i. Ecco la mia soluzione nel modello, e come si vede, il modulo di z cresce. Dati iniziali partono da 1 più i, ma il modulo cresce, quindi questo non può essere oscillatorio, perché vediamo che il modulo cresce esponenzialmente. Questo è un modo per ripetere lo stesso approccio come nel caso generico, solo io ho sostituito z con x più y e considerato separatamente l'equazione per x, eccolo, e l'equazione per y.
Ok, grazie mille.
Ok, quindi questa volta noi abbiamo studiato il caso quando questo coefficiente è numero reale. La prossima volta si vede quando eventualmente abbiamo un numero complesso, ma per il momento qui ci fermiamo la registrazione e la prossima volta domani cerco di presentarmi nel polo San Rossore. Ci sono studenti che vanno a San Rossore?
Sì.
Sì.
Voi avete dalle 9 alle 11 lezioni, 11 meno un quarto? E subito dopo iniziamo, verso le 11 si inizia, se ho capito bene.
Il mercoledì intendi?
Sì.
Domani?
Sì, allora sì.
Ok, proviamo se si può lavorare così. Per gli altri studenti che non possono partecipare, prego di avere un po' di pazienza perché non so con queste nuove condizioni come funzionerà. In ogni caso cerco di collegarmi via Edoron verso le 11 domani. Ok, allora grazie per l'attenzione e a domani. Domani iniziamo con le vostre domande.
A domani. Grazie.
Grazie, arrivederci.
Arrivederci.
Arrivederci.